first order gas phase reaction. For that, consider one gas phase reaction, first order gas phase reaction. Okay, see, let us consider a typical first order gas phase reaction, first order gas phase reaction. Okay, that is A reacts and gives B moles of B plus C, which are in gaseous state. Let us consider the first order gas phase reaction. See, the reactant A will decompose into B plus C, which are in gas phase. Okay, now take Pi is the initial pressure of A. And Pt is the total pressure at time t seconds. Okay, that is at time t seconds, Pt equal to partial pressure of A plus partial pressure of B plus partial pressure of C. Pt equal to Pa plus Pb plus Pc, where Pa, Pb, Pc are, right here. Right. That is at time t seconds. At t seconds, Pt equal to Pa plus Pb plus Pc, where Pa comma Pb comma Pc are partial pressures of A comma B comma C, respectively at time t seconds. Okay, what is Pt? Pt is the total pressure at time t seconds. That means total pressure means that is at time t seconds, Pt equal to Pa plus Pb plus Pc, where Pa, Pb, Pc are partial pressures of A, B, C respectively at a time t seconds. T equal to 0 seconds. The pressure of initial pressure of A is Pi. Okay? At a time t equal to t seconds, the pressure of C is x atmospheres and V is x atmospheres. Then how much is the pressure of A means P initial minus x atmospheres. Initially Pi atmospheres. Okay, so then what is the pressure means Pi minus x atmospheres. Okay, at a time t seconds, if the pressure of C is x atmospheres and pressure of B is x atmospheres, then the pressure of A becomes P initial minus x atmospheres. That is Pi minus x atmospheres. Okay, that is the point. Okay, now we know that yet time t seconds Pt, which is total pressure equal to Pa plus Pb plus Pc na? Pa plus Pb plus Pc. Therefore, on substituting the partial pressures of APC in this equation, we will get Pt equal to partial pressure of A is Pi minus x at time t, Pi minus x, plus partial pressure of B is x atmospheres, partial pressure of C is x atmospheres. Then Pt equal to Pi minus Pi, this one cancel, Pi plus x. Therefore, we can say P total minus Pi equal to x. Pt minus Pi equal to x. P total minus P initial equal to x. That is the x atmospheres. Okay. So that means what is the meaning here? P total minus P initial will give the atmospheres. How much atmospheres of C and B are formed? Okay. Now see, here the rate constant of this first order gas phase reaction is given as K equal to 2.303 by T into log of initial pressure by partial pressure of A at time T. Partial pressure of A at time T. Or we can write Pa. Pa means nothing but partial pressure of A at time T na. Initially we assume na. Pm is nothing but partial pressure of A at time t. Now, according to this data, substitute here. K equal to 2.303 by T into log of P initial. P initial means initial pressure is Pa. Initial pressure of the reactant A is Pa minus P. Pa minus Pa. Pm means how much? Pm means how much? This is nothing but Pn. It is the Pa. Means nothing but Pa. Pa means partial pressure of A at time t. Partial pressure of A at time t. So that is how much? Pa minus x. That is how much? Pa minus x. Therefore, K equal to 2.303 by T into log of Pi by Pi minus of x. X value is how much? Pt minus Pa. Pt minus Pa. Therefore, what we get? K equal to 2.303 by T into log of Pi by 2 into Pi minus Pt. 2 into Pi minus Pt. It is the reintegrated rate law for first order gas phase reaction. Okay. It is the integrated rate equation for first order gas phase reaction. Okay. So, rate constant of first order gas phase reaction is given as K equal to 2.303 by T into log of Pi by 2 into Pi minus Pt. Okay. Solve one problem. Okay. We are going to solve one problem based on this concept. Okay. See once. See the given data. The following data are obtained during a first order thermal decomposition of N2O5. Decomposition of N2O5 at a constant volume. See, that N2O5 is decomposed to N2O4 plus O2. Okay? So, the data is given. See, if you take a first experiment, at time t equal to 0 seconds, the total pressure is 0.5 atmospheres. See the condition here. At a time t equal to 0 seconds means nothing but partial pressure of the pressure of the reactant. At time t equal to 0 seconds, the decomposition is initially, the decomposition was together, the products formation was 0. Therefore, there is no products. So only reactant is present in the vessel. Only the reactant is present in the vessel. at time t equal to 0 seconds. What are the components present in the vessel means? See, only reactant is left. Therefore, we can say this 0.25 atmospheres is the pressure of N2O5 at t equal to 0 seconds. At t equal to 0 seconds, partial pressure of N2O5 is 0.5. Okay, at if you observe the second data, see at a time 100 seconds, the total pressure is 0.512. It is nothing but Pt, P total. It is nothing but P total, that is nothing but P total, that is at time t, that is at time t. Nothing but P total at a time 100 seconds. At a time, which time? 100 seconds. Okay. Now see the, take this equation once again. N2O5. We use N2O4 plus O2. Balance the equation to 2 and it is 1. Gaseous phase. See once again. Now, at a time t equals 0 seconds, the total pressure is how much? 0.5. So at time t equals 0 seconds, total pressure is 0.5, which is equal to the pressure of N2O5 only. Okay, that is 0.5 atmospheres. Then at the time t equal to 0 seconds, partial pressure of N2O5 is 0 atmospheres and O2 is also 0 atmospheres. Okay. Now, at time t seconds, at a time t seconds, means like, we'll see, time t seconds, how much of the react, how much of the O2 is formed means, what is the pressure of O2 means? X atmospheres. And the pressure of N2O5 means 2 into X atmospheres. Then what is the pressure of N2O5 means? 0.5 P initial, 0.5 atmospheres minus 2x. 0.5 atmospheres minus 2x. At a time t seconds, what is the pressure of N2O5 means? 0.5 atmospheres minus 2 into x. Okay. Whereas time t equal to t seconds, what is the pressure? What is the pressure of N2O4 means? 2x atmospheres. Pressure of water means x atmospheres. Pressure of water is x atmospheres. Okay, now see the at time t equal to 100 seconds, at time t equal to 100 seconds, p total equal to partial pressure of N2O5 plus partial pressure of N2O4 plus partial pressure of O2. Partial pressure of N2O5 plus partial pressure of N2O4 plus partial pressure of O2. At a time t seconds, what is the partial pressure of O2? That is x. N2O4, 2x. Then this is 0.5 minus 2x, which is equal to Pt. Okay. Now, then if you observe this, these two are getting cancelled. Therefore, what you will get? Pt equal to 0.5 plus x. 0.5 plus x. That is x equal to Pt minus 0.5. Pt minus 0.5. Okay. Now, if we take at t equal to 100 seconds, Pt is how much? 0.512. Pt is how much? 0.512. At time t equal 100 seconds, partial pressure of N2O5 equal to 0.5 minus 2x. Okay, 0.5 minus 2x. Therefore, partial pressure of N2O5 equal to 0.5 minus 2 into 2 into Pt minus 0.5. That is how much? 0.5 minus 2 Pt plus 1. That is how much? 1.5 minus 2 Pt. 1.5 minus 2 Pt. Therefore, at a time t equal 100 seconds, Pt is how much? 0.512. Therefore, 1.5 minus 2 into 0.512. That is how much? 1.5 minus 2 to 4, 2, 2 plus 10, 0, 1.024, 1.024. That is how much? 0.476 atmospheres. That is PN2O5. N2O5 is 0.476 atmospheres. Okay? PN2O5 at 100 seconds. At 100 seconds. Therefore, the K equal to integrated rate law. K equal to formula is there now 2.303 by T into log of P initial by partial pressure of A. Partial pressure of A at MT. Partial pressure of A at MT. That is K equal to 2.303 by T value. T value is 100 seconds into log of P initial is 0.5. 0.5 by 0.476. Okay? Here this value is the log of 0.5 by 0.476 is 0.216 into 2.303 by 100. And finally you get 4.98 into. Finally, what is the value means? Final result of this, result is K equal to 4.98 into 10 power minus 4 seconds. Sorry, second inverse you get. Okay, this is the value of this one. This one value. Next, what are pseudo first order reactions? Pseudo first order reactions. See, what are pseudo first order reactions means simply those reactions which are not truly first order, but due to certain conditions they became a first order. Those are said to be first order reactions. So some examples if you are taken means here, see one example, ester hydrolysis. Ester hydrolysis, if you are taken means hydrolysis of ester, you are taken means CH3 C double bond O C2H5 on hydrolysis will gives CH3 C double bond O OH plus C2H5 OH. If you observe this reaction, ester hydrolysis. Here, for this reaction, rate is directly proportional to ester power 1 and concentration of H2O power 0. Why you are taking it as 0 means, if you observe this ester hydrolysis, the rate of this chemical reaction will depends on concentration of ester only, doesn't depends on H2O. Why it doesn't depend on H2O means only one point we have, that is a very very important point, that is in a chemical reaction, the rate of any chemical reaction doesn't depend on concentration of a reactant which is present in excess. That means in ester hydrolysis, which is the excess reactant means ester is the water is the excess. So water is the excess quantity. Therefore, rate doesn't depend on this term. That means those reactions in which the reactant is x is, then rate doesn't depends on that reactant. Okay, that means in a chemical reaction, if one of the reactant is present in excess, rate doesn't depends on that reactant. That is called. That's why the order, actually order molecularity of this reaction is how much? 2 are there, molecularity is 2. But the order is how much? 1 plus 0, 1. Order is how much? 1 only. But molecularity is 2. So with respect to molecularity, we are expected order is second order. But really, it is not a first order. It is, sorry, it is not a second order. It is a first order. Okay, so what are pseudo first order reactions means? These are the reactions which are not truly first order, but due to certain conditions, they became a first order, or called as pseudo first order reactions. And one more example, if you are taken, means inversion of cane sugar. See, if we take inversion of cane sugar. C12 H22 O11 on hydrolysis in the presence of acid will gives C6 H12O6 glucose fructose. Okay, see, if you observe this reaction, here rate expression is given as rate is directly proportional to C12, H22, or we can take sugar. Concentration of sucrose power 1 and concentration of H2O power 0. Here also, the rate of this chemical reaction is depends on concentration of sugar, doesn't depend on H2O. Why? Because means rate is present in excess. That H2O is present in excess. That's why rate doesn't depend on concentration of H2O. That means what is the phenomenon here? In any chemical reaction, if one of the reactant is present in excess, rate doesn't depend on that reactant. Rate of a reaction doesn't depend on that reactant. Okay? That is called as pseudo first order condition. Okay? Therefore, what is the definition of pseudo first order means? Pseudo first order means these are the reactions. This is the definition. These are the reactions which are not truly first order, which are not truly first order due to certain conditions becomes first order. These are the reactions which are not truly first order, but due to certain conditions becomes a first order. Okay, are said to be pseudo first order reactions. What is the main principle here means, in a chemical reaction, if one of the reactant is present in excess quantity, then that the chemical rate of the chemical reaction doesn't depend on that reactant. Okay, that is the condition. If we take ester hydrolysis, here H2O is present in excess because it is a solvent here, present in excess. Therefore, rate of this hydrolysis, rate of ester hydrolysis doesn't depend on concentration of H2O. It depends only on the ester. And if we take inversion of cane sugar, and the inversion of cane sugar, the rate of this chemical reaction is depends on concentration of sucrose only, doesn't depend on H2O. That is the phenomenon. Okay.